Okay, unfortunately, at this point, spring tension is lost. So what happened was I lost spring tension and the roller door and the drum have buckled on the supporting ladder. So at this point, having lost spring tension, we're now going to start to build spring tension, fix the situation and move forward. So we start by pulling down on the front of the drum, and then as the roller door winds onto the drum, we pull down on the front of the roller door to pull the door back onto the drum. To build spring tension, you will need a big plumber's clamp. Here are the tools I use. That's a plumber's wrench. It's a fairly big one. You adjust it like that, and you can turn the rod inside the metal drum on the roller door to increase or decrease spring tension. This here is a 12 volt screw gun. It has an adapter for a socket extension. Okay, and that's how I tightened up the bolts on the U-bolt to secure the metal rod inside the drum. You'll have to back off the bolts and wind the shaft inside the drum and keep on with that technique. I'll just say at this point also that professional roller door installers would have a different technique to mine. I'm doing this job for the first time. Although I didn't have problems with losing spring tension when I installed the motors back in, I think, 2008. Please note that when installing the new roller door motor, I have a ratchet strap around the drum and the roller door. Also, the roller door supported over a beam on top of the roller door on the ceiling. So please support the roller door first, just in case you lose spring tension. I found that the ribbing design of the roller door itself gives the impression that the roller door won't move after spring tension is lost. And of course, once you remove the support, the ladder underneath, or whatever it is you're using, the roller door will fall to the ground. Not the drum, not the entire thing. It'll stay on the bracket, but it'll just unwind. I'm starting to think that maybe the best way to put a new roller door motor on is to actually back off spring tension, install it, and then build spring tension once the new motors installed. Okay, now what can happen here is you can lose spring tension. It can unravel. Now, I think I've got the job turned around now. So I've undone these bolts and I've released the clutch so that you can turn. It's still got a lot of tension on it, and you use these plumbing clamps to tighten it up, because essentially you got two parts, possibly with a spring in the middle on this shaft here going to the other side. However, I've found that if I tighten this up, I can still turn it and it won't go back the other way at the moment. Things could change when the spring tension starts to build up, but I'll attempt to record it. Okay, it started to rain, so that's what the noise is all about. But here you can see the bracket. And what happened was, when I loosened that off, it unwound and I lost the spring tension. So that's fairly tight at the moment, but I am able to grip onto here and turn this around, but it won't spring back yet. So I am starting to get spring tension. So the moral of the story is, don't undo the bracket on the opposite side of the motor. Just demonstrate that I can't lift the garage door. As I said, I have got some spring tension, so I was able to move it. So for this, I am wearing gloves and some form of eye protection. Okay, so that's the limit. As you can see, that's now coming back. So I'm going to have to tighten it a little bit more. I think it's this one here. Okay, I'll go ahead and tighten that a bit more. Okay, now that is fully tightened. It's on the full spring tension. I'm going to bring the roller door up, but I can't lift it up. I have to roll it. I have to roll it down. I'll show that now. Okay, now that the roller door's up, I've loosened the clamp off, but there's no tension on it anymore because the roller door's up. So what I'll do is now retension it. Okay, I'll just tighten that up a bit more. Okay, success. Now, we just have to put the new motor in. Yeah, so how it works is the opposite sides of the motor is the one that's under tension. So never undo the opposite side. Okay, otherwise you'll have to do the work that I've just shown to get the spring tension. Now, what we're going to do next is we're going to support the roller door. We're going to put a rope over to hold it on the ladder. And we're going to remove the bracket and take the old motor off, put the new motor on. Now, one thing I have noticed is this didn't come with the metal rods, so there's supposed to be two metal rods here, but it's not anywhere in the box. So, yeah, didn't come with that. It's a good idea to have the metal bits in there. This is what we're using. Okay, so we've got the roller door supported. This ratchet strap goes right over the top, back around, hooks in here, and it's tightened up. The roller door weight is supported. You can see there. So now we'll just take off the bracket and that'll be free floating, and we'll swap over the motors and take it from there. Okay, so we can see that there's not much room there, and the metal rods only just fit into place. I think these could possibly be from the 1970s, this roller door. So we've got about 40 millimeters on that side, so I'd say possibly push it in. It's bottomed out on something, so. I'll get that sorted out now, but that's the most of the work done.